Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I want to talk about area of polygons, and I have a formula sheet here that I want to talk about a little bit. If you want to find the perimeter of a polygon, you just add all the sides, and there's different formulas for that, but that's the simplest way to think about it. Area equals length times width is if you have a rectangle. Area equals base times height is for a parallelogram. Area equals pi r squared is for a circle. For our purposes, for pi, we'll either use 3.14 or 22 sevenths, depending on what we're asked to use. And base times height divided by 2 is a triangle. Big base plus little base divided by 2 times height is a trapezoid. And circumference equals diameter times pi. That's similar to perimeter, where circumference is just the distance around a circle. Anytime you see a pi, you know there's some kind of circle involved. And then volume is length times width times height. And we'll refer back to this on other videos, so I just wanted to have this basic formula chart there. So the first one I'm looking at asks you to find the area of a rectangle. And we just saw the rectangle formula, and that was area equals length times width. And so in this formula, in this picture, I mean, we have a length of 11.1, and we have a width of 7.1. And so I'm just going to multiply those two things together. And I'm going to use a calculator, and you're welcome to use a calculator as well. So 11.1 times 7.1 is 78.81. I'm not going to talk about significant digits here, but I want you to realize that you have to look at whatever your test or whatever you're doing and see if they ask you to round to a specific place. But that's not all I want to do here. I want to state my final answer. I'm going to round to the tenth because I had just the tenths going in. And then I'm going to put my unit down. Now, when I talk about area, it's the space inside here. And if you think about space going vertically and horizontally, do you see how we get little squares in there? Because it's two-dimensional. So every time we find the area of something, our units have to be to the second power. So we had meters and we had meters. And if you take meters times meters, you get meters squared. So the formula is length times width, and the unit has to be to the second power. What if we had a square? Well, a square is really just a rectangle in disguise. And if it's a square, then all four sides are the same. So if one side is 14.6, then the other side is also 14.6. And I would take 14.6 times itself, and I could write that as 14.6 squared. Either way, it doesn't matter. We're going to get the same answer. So if I take 14.6 times 14.6, I get 213.16. And then I'm going to round that to the tenths. And because I have a 6 here, I'm going to round that to 2. And what are my units going to be? Well, the units are going to be inches to the second power. Always to the second power when we're doing that. And the next one, we're looking at a triangle. And that triangle also, I gave that up above, the formula for that. Formula for a triangle is area equals base times height divided by 2. And why am I dividing by 2? Well, if you extended this out, this triangle out, you could see that the triangle, that didn't show up very well, the triangle is really like half of a parallelogram. And a parallelogram is just base times height. So for a triangle, we do base times height, but we only have half of that. That's why we divide by 2. And sometimes you'll see the formula written like this, 1/2 base times height, which is the same thing, dividing by 2 or multiplying by 1/2. So we're going to take our base which is 9 1/2. And I'm going to write that as an improper fraction. So I have 9 times 2 is 18 plus 1 is 19 halves. And then I have the 8, which I'm going to write as 8 over 1. And for our purposes, because we're dealing with fractions, I'm going to go ahead and multiply by 1/2 rather than dividing by 2, because that way it kind of looks nicer to me. Now I can do a little cross-canceling here. 2 goes into itself once, into 8 4 times, and then I can multiply those together. And that would be 19 times 4 on the top, which is 76, over 1 times 1 times 2 on the bottom, which is 2. And then I'm just going to take 76, divide by 2, which would give me 38, and that's going to be my area. But what's going to be the unit? Well, I had yards. Every time I find an area, I always have units to the second power. So it's 38 yards squared. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is a circle. And for the circle, remember, we always have to think about pi. And I had said in the other one that we're going to use 3.14 or 22/7. So I'm going to use 3.14 here for the area. The area formula is pi r squared. And r means radius. And what we're giving here is a diameter. And so half of 13 is be the radius. Well, half of 13 is 6.5. Still going to be inches, but if I look at half of 13, I'm going to get 6.5 or 6.5. And so I'm going to take area equals pi times 6.5 squared. Now, if you do this and they ask you for an exact answer, that means they don't want you to approximate pi, because that makes it obviously not exact at that point because you've approximated. So what they want you to do for an exact answer is just take your 6.5 squared, and that would be 42.25, and just leave the pi in there. If you leave pi, then we say that that is exact. But our units were inches, so we're talking about inches squared. Now, if we want the approximation, then we're going to go ahead and multiply 42.4 or 42.25 times 3.14. So the approximation, we put the pi value in and we approximate. And then instead of equals, we are going to put an approximation sign times 3.14. And that's going to give me approximately 132.665. And again, I'm going to go back and round that off depending on what the whatever I'm working with asked me to round it to. So because I had one decimal point there, I'm going to go ahead and round it and say that that's 132.7. I'm going to put the approximation symbols in there, because 6, 1 besides 6 was a 6, so that would round that up to 7. And again, that's inches squared. All right, the next one, area of a trapezoid. Well, a trapezoid doesn't go straight up on each side, so you have to look at the big base and the little base and find their average and then multiply by the height. So the formula, there's more than one way you'll see this, but if you look at it this way, times height, you can see that we're taking the big base plus the little base and dividing by 2. That gives us an average width, and then you multiply that times height. But there's other ways to write that, and that's fine if you see it as times 1/2 rather than divided by 2. But our big base here is 16, and our smaller base is 12, and we're dividing that by 2, and then our height is 11. So if I add 16 and 12, I get 28, and divide by 2, I get 14, and then 14 times 11 is going to be 154, and then I need to decide what my unit's going to be. Well, I'm going to use the unit meters that I started off with, but because it's area, it's going to be meters to the second power. And finally, the last one is a parallelogram. And a parallelogram, like I said, it's twice as much as a triangle, right? If you cut that in half, you'd see you get triangle on each side. So the formula for an area of a parallelogram is just base times height. And so I know my base is 14, and I know my height is 12 and a quarter. Well, I'm going to change that into an improper fraction to work this problem. I'm going to say this is 14 over 1, and this is 12 times 4 is 48, plus 1 is 49 over 4. I could do a little canceling here because 2 goes into 14 7 times, and it goes into 4 twice, and that might make things a little nicer for me. But overall, not so great. I've got to do 7 times 49. Which is 343 over 2. And if I want to round that off to, they have fractions. I mean, we'll just leave it as a fraction, huh? I like 343 over 2. And also, if I wanted to write that as a fraction, it's 171 and 1/2. That would be okay as well, but the unit has to be on there. And this, we were talking about feet, so we would talk about feet to the second power. So there's all those area shapes, and hope you have a great day.